Hi, today I'm going to talk about files and hyperlinks. This will help keep your project team up to date on the latest documents and changes. I'm going to go here to the Files tab. Now, the difference between the Files tab and the Plans tab is that anything you upload to the Files tab will be kept in a bound multi-page document. Anything you upload to the Plans tab will be separated out into individual sheets. I will click plus new file here, and I can utilize any of these sources to upload from, or I'm just going to add some files from my computer. On the Files tab, you can upload PDFs, Word documents, Excel files, and several other formats. Generally, the most commonly used type of files are specifications, change orders, RFIs, requests for information, reports, submittals, shop drawings, operation and maintenance manuals, as well as any general project documents. You can organize your files just like your plans. Let's add a couple folders. I'll select the files I want to move and click in the Actions tab, Move to Folder. I can now open and close these folders, which, as you can imagine, can be valuable as you have more and more files on your project. Anyone in my project will now be able to go to the Files tab and view any of the documents uploaded here. One of these change orders has affected my plans, but a new drawing has not yet been issued. I'm going to attach it to my plan so my project team knows the latest updates. I'll go to the plan affected, click the link tool here, and select this paperclip icon. I'll place it on the room, and either I can upload a brand new attachment or search in the existing files that I've already uploaded to my project. Now, anyone can click on the document and see the change. I'll also add a cloud just for clarity. Now, when I go back to the Files tab, you'll see that there's a plan sheet listed under the Links column next to this ASK. I can click here if I want to jump to see that plan where this document was linked. You can add links to as many plans as you'd like. Let's run through the other information you can see here on the Files tab. You can see who the document was uploaded by, the date and time. This up arrow will allow you to replace the file, but keep all of the existing links. If you have an RFI that was changed, you can simply upload a new version of the file while maintaining the links on your drawings. You can download the file individually, you can edit the name, and you can delete the file. Up here at the top, under the Actions tab, you can export all of your files. So that's an overview of how the files and file hyperlinks work. Stay tuned for the next video, which will go over markups and annotations. Thanks!